Hey guys, George Vesemi here, and today I wanted to do a quick how-to on how to bring your data from ClickSense's web connectors into the ClickSense platform. Now, everybody knows that Qlik can connect to a wide variety of different data sources. You can point it to files on the local server or on Dropbox. You can connect to databases and data warehouses such as Microsoft SQL Server, Oracle, and Snowflake. And you can also connect to applications such as Salesforce. Now, one of the questions that I get asked pretty frequently is, George, I don't see my data connection on here. How do I connect to it? Well, for databases, you can use the ODBC or OLEDB connector to connect to practically any database out there. And then with the REST connector or the web file, you can connect to all of your different applications and whatnot. Now, there's another way to connect to your data, though, that doesn't require the REST connector, and that is through the Qlik web connectors. So let me go hop over to that screen. And here you can see that I have a wide variety of different connectors. I think we have 46 in total. And this can connect to a lot of different applications, such as Facebook, Google Analytics, Jira, MailChimp. There's really a lot out there. And then over here in the standard connections, you have some more object storage as well as file connections. And what I'm going to show off is connecting to an Amazon S3 bucket. So if I click on this connector, what I'm going to want to do is I'm going to get the raw object as text, but you have actually the ability to pull in things like metadata as well. Now in the parameters, I point it to the bucket that I have as well as the file and the authentication. And when I run this, what this is going to do is it's going to generate a quick data preview to show that we've pulled in the file, and this is the file that we have. And then I'm going to go over here to ClickSense standard mode, and I'm going to copy this URL to the clipboard. Now, this URL is essentially going to be able to be plugged into a data connection. So if I go over here to, let's say, S3 test, I can just put that URL in here, and you see that I've already created it ahead of time. And when I save that and run it, I'm able to pull in my S3 data into ClickSense. So it's as easy as that. As long as you have the credentials, you should easily be able to navigate all of these different data sources that the Qlik web connectors can provide. So that's all I got, guys. If you want to learn more about ClickSense or the Qlik web connectors, feel free to reach out to us in the comments below or at info@smesgroup.com. Bye, guys.